गुड
मॉर्निंग मैम।
मॉर्निंग मैम।
लास्ट क्लास वी
गुड
डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एजुकेशन, राइट? आई थिंक वी फिनिश्ड द टॉपिक एजुकेशन। एजुकेशन, हाउ एजुकेशन इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन ह्यूमन कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन एंड द स्टेप्स टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू इम्प्रूव द एजुकेशन सेक्टर, इजंट इट?
यस मैम।
यस। सो what are the steps taken in India for the spread of education?
Vocational education.
Okay, Rifa, one point. Promotion of vocation education. Good. Then Anjita.
Yes, ma'am.
Another point,
ma'am.
Anjita, steps taken by the India government for the promotion of education. If your audio is not working proper, use the chat box. Okay, then Hadi. Hadi.
Yes, ma'am.
Another point. What all things the government did for the spread of education?
Ma'am, your voice is cracking. I can't hear you.
The steps taken by the government for the promotion of education. Now also it's cracking, Hadi. Hadi Dev.
Yes, ma'am.
Any one point?
By conducting schemes and programs.
Which scheme? For the universalization of education. Which project? Children, you are not revising proper.
Ma'am, for better health conscious.
Education, we discussed about a term is there for promoting the universalization of education. What is it?
सर्व शिक्षा अभियान.
वेरी गुड वेरी गुड वेरी गुड. इट्स सर्व शिक्षा अभियान फॉर द यूनिवर्सलाइजेशन ऑफ एजुकेशन. द गवर्नमेंट इंप्लीमेंटेड द सर्व शिक्षा अभियान. देन व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स द गवर्नमेंट डिड? मिड डे मील प्रोग्राम. वेरी गुड एमिल. मिड डे मील प्रोग्राम. देन
राइट टू एजुकेशन इन
एजुकेशन. सॉरी,
राइट टू एजुकेशन.
Okay, Nirbhama, good. Right to Education Act. Then,
and many more colleges, universities, and
yes. Colleges and universities. Increase the number of colleges and universities. Okay, good. So, children, revise the topics. So the vocational education has been introduced. The plan outlay, that point you didn't say. The plan outlay for education has been increased. Now there is no planning commission. Instead of that, which body is there? Which one?
Niti Aayog.
National Institution for Transforming India. Niti Aayog. Now there is no planning commission. Then Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan has been launched for providing the elementary education, for the universalization of elementary education for the children belonging to the age group of 6 to 14. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Then midday meal program started. Then the universities and colleges, technical institutions has been started, and the Right to Education Act has been passed. Now it is a fundamental right of the child and fundamental duty of the parent to be educated. Fundamental duty of the parent to give education to the children, and it's a fundamental right of a child to be educated. Okay. So that's all about the health. So children revise from the beginning. We studied people as a resource, then the difference between a physical capital and a human capital. Then why people are more superior than any other resource. Then we discussed the role or the importance of education. Then about the three sectors of the economy. Which were the three sectors, Vishnupriya?
Primary.
Secondary.
Tertiary.
Very good, Hadid. It's tertiary. Primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. Primary sector means they are using the agricultural products or the primary products from the nature, right? Secondary sector, what they are doing?
Processing.
They are transforming a primary product into a finished good. And the tertiary sector, it is called as a service sector. Actually, they are not producing anything. What they are doing? They act as an aid or a support to the primary and secondary sector.
Primary and secondary.
Then we discuss the role of education and what are the steps taken by the government for the spread of education. It include the vocationalized. If a question is there, explain the steps taken by the government for the promotion of education. What should be your answer? Vocationalization of education. The plan outlay has been increased. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, midday meal program, Right to Education, and also increase the number of universities, colleges, and technical institutions. Right? Children, before, if you know the point, then you can write it. Okay. So the first important source of human capital formation is education, and the next one is health. What about health? Now, why you are attending online class in the current society? Why?
Corona.
Why corona? Why we are so much caring about our cleanliness or about the health? Why we are so much caring about this? Because it will affect the health, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
What happens if our health is, if we are not healthy, what will happen? Or a ill health person, what is the problem?
He can't work or study.
He can't work or study proper, right? In the case of Sahal and Vilas itself, if you analyze, Vilas is suffering from arthritis, right? So it automatically affects his studies. And also, what about the working condition? Who will work more? And a healthy person or an unhealthy person?
Healthy.
Healthy persons can contribute more to the... A healthy person can contribute more than an unhealthy person, right? So the second important source of human capital formation is health. Then how we can improve the health condition? Now you know, because now we are all facing a situation which will affect our health. How we can solve this problem? How can become more healthy?
Eating healthy food.
By eating, okay, which food. Type of food?
Healthy
or nutritious food, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then?
Drinking a lot
by
of water.
Taking medicines.
Yeah, okay, by taking medicines. See, how you heard about vaccinations?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now we are fearing corona because there is no vaccine for that disease, right?
Yes, ma'am.
See, when you are a child, the time when we born itself, we will start taking vaccinations. When you are 3 months, 6 months, or 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, I think for the 15, at your age of 15 also, you have one vaccination. So why we are taking all these vaccinations? Polio, have you heard about polio?
Yes,
ma'am.
Why we are giving all these vaccinations in a correct time?
To get immunity.
Immunity or to prevent such type of diseases. So if we have a healthy population, it is an asset to a nation. Our population is healthy, it is an asset to a nation. But what about the unhealthy population?
Not asset.
Become a liability to a nation. Healthy populations are always an asset to a nation, and unhealthy population is a liability to a nation. What do you mean by liability to a nation? Why we are saying like that? Because they cannot work proper, right? 2 persons are working, a healthy and an unhealthy person. Who can contribute more to the production?
Healthy,
because if an unhealthy person is there, he need leaves. And also, COVID vaccination, 19 vaccination is found. Yes, many agencies are going on with that, but nothing become a success till this year. There will not be any vaccine like that. I heard the news. You didn't hear like that. Vaccines, many companies are developing the vaccines. But we don't know how much successful it is. Only when we are giving this. From
August, October.
That was the first news we heard. And the next 2 or 3 days back, I heard a news like that. Oh, so happy. No. It will be under control after October. It's going to be the peak time. Then it will be calm down. We can hope so. Hope for the best. Okay. Then we discussed about health. So health is a most important factor. Or a source of human capital formation. Only a healthy population become an asset to a country. See, in India, all the people are sick. Can we say population as an asset?
No.
Why?
It's a liability.
It's a liability, definitely. If unhealthy population is there, it become a liability to a nation. Then, how to define health? What do you mean by health? How you will define health? How?
Anybody? Health is ability to fight.
If it is wrong, it's okay. You just...
Less percentage of body fat.
Okay.
Estate.
Then any other
state of
health is ability to fight illness.
Adidev, Lolita, what you said?
Ability to fight illness.
Okay. Then Adidev.
Health is a state in which we prevent illness and injuries.
In simple way we can define health like that, but a definition for health. Can you see this? It is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being. So we all define health only in the sense that it's a physical well-being, right? But it is not only health, is not only mental health, social well-being, and also not merely the absence of diseases or infirmity. That is one of the most important definition for health. It is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being. I think it's a new definition for you, right?
Yes.
Yes. So health, yes, is a state of complete. You all define health in the physical sense, but health means it is not only include the physical, also the mental. So the physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. That is definition for health. It's a complete physical, mental, and social well-being. Only then we can call that person as a healthy person. Okay. Then, what is the role of health in human capital formation? We discussed, you remember we discussed the role of education in human capital formation? It helped them to earn higher income.
Yes.
Yes, like that. What is the role of health in human capital formation?
It creates well-being of human life.
Okay, it helps to create well-being of human life. Then? Then any other? Think and answer. I told you, if it is wrong, it's
helps
okay.
Helps to person to fight illness.
Okay, the role of health in human capital formation. How the healthy population can contribute to human capital formation? If he's healthy, he can contribute more to human cap, to the society, right? Then any other point?
Manpower is required in tertiary and primary, secondary.
Okay. So we need healthy manpower. Only then productivity will increase. Okay. Then, any other? How the better healthy?
I have only videos of. Is there any problem?
Some of them informed that they have some technical problems. Hence, Steve and all informed.
Now they are coming on. I think they are purposely switching off.
Hence Steve informed that he has some technical problem. Whereas nobody informed anything.
On you, on your videos, if constantly you are off, you will be taken out of the class.
I informed that, sir, in the beginning of the class itself.
Matyush, you have any problem? Johan, Savio, Steve, Afsana.
Savio also informed, sir. He has some technical problem.
Johan, Steve, Steve.
Sir, I have a problem, sir.
You have to know whether you are in class or not. Okay, carry on.
So we can check the role of health. First one is, the health make a person efficient in his work. The point you said, it increases productivity. Only a healthy person can work more without taking any leaves or any other problem. If he's healthy, he can work more. So it helps to increase the productivity. So first, the role of health in human capital formation. Most important point is, it helps to increase the productivity. Second one, good health enable a person to be regular in his work. That is also very important. If he's a healthy person, there is no need for taking leaves in between for any checkups or all. So it will help him to be regular in his work. So first point is, it helps to increase the productivity. It helps to increase the productivity. Second point, it helps enable the person to be regular in his work. Third one, good physical health promote mental health and adds quality of life. Nowadays, in the situation of corona, you can see that it affects the mental health of the people. People are feared about the disease. Those who are affected also, it affected their mental status too. Okay, so the health doesn't mean only the physical health. It includes both physical as well as mental well-being of the people. So what is the role of health in human capital formation? It helps to increase the productivity, and also it helps the people to be regular in their work. Those who are physically healthy, they also become mentally healthy. Clear?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, yes, what's the role of health in human capital formation? It helps to increase productivity. Then,
enables a person to be regular in his work.
Enable a person to be regular in his work. Then,
mental
adds quality to his life.
It also helps the promote the mental health, which improve the quality of life of the people.
Of the creative.
Right. The next point we are going to discuss is unemployment. Have you heard about the term unemployment?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What do you mean by unemployment?
Without job.
Without job. Okay. Is unemployment. See, children. I am purposefully deciding I am not ready to do a job. Wait. I am purposefully deciding I am not going to do any job. Am I unemployed?
No.
No.
Why?
Unemployed means
to do that job.
Not getting a job.
Okay, sorry.
Unemployment.
If a person willing only
to do that job.
Yes. If a person is willing to do a job, right? If a person is willing to do a job at the existing wage rate, the two things is important. If I'm ready to work in the existing wage rate, I am willing, I'm ready to do the job, but I am not getting any job. Only then you can call me an unemployed person. So unemployment is a situation in which the people are willing to work, but they are not able to find a job. And also we studied about Sahal, right?
Yes.
He has one younger brother and a sister. Can we call them unemployed?
No.
Why?
They are very small.
Yes. So we have a working population. Okay. We have a working population that include in between the age group of 15 to 59. So the population coming in between the age group of 15 to 59. In the beginning of the chapter, we discussed about China. You remember that? Why they changed their one policy now?
Yes.
Why? Because their working population is less. Their dependency population is more. The people above the age of 59 or below the age of 15 are dependent population. So the working population include the people in between the age group of 15 to 59. So the persons who are coming under that category, and if they are willing to work at the existing wage rate, but they are not able to find a job, we can call them as unemployed. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then how to define unemployment? It is a situation in which a person who is able to work and willing to work. The two terms are very, very important when you are defining the unemployment. The person is able to work and willing to work, but doesn't find a gainful employment. It is called as unemployment. Okay. One of the most important problem India is facing now. It's also boosted by Corona. You know, nowadays many of the Gulf countries, I think the latest news is from Kuwait, right?
Yes, ma'am.
They decided to send back.
Yes, ma'am.
Many of the Indians, they are decided to send back. So it will boost the problem of unemployment. One of the most important economic impact of Corona is also unemployment. Many people lost the job. And also nowadays, I think you know the situation very well. And the yesterday's yes, or day before yesterday's newspaper about the Kuwait government decided to send back many of the people, and it include around 15 or 8 lakh of Indians. They are planning to send back to India. That means again it will boost the problem of unemployment. It is a situation in which the people are ready to work at the existing wage rate, but they are not able to get a job. That is unemployment. Then you know any type of unemployment, children? Okay, before going to that, why unemployment is considered as a serious problem? What are the consequences of unemployment?
Because without unemployment,
there won't be
unemployment. There will be a slow.
A little bit louder, child.
There will be no flow of money around the country.
Okay. It will affect the income of the people, right? Then, who told Rifa? Okay, it will affect the income of the people. Yes.
If they won't.
Wait. Okay, let her speak. Okay, Rifa?
They won't get the income, so they won't be able to feed the family.
Okay. Then
development will slow down.
Very good.
It will lead to poverty.
Very good.
The economic status will decrease.
Economic status will decrease. Yes. Any other point anybody want to add? All these are correct answers. One of the most important reason for poverty itself is unemployment. Yes, Adidev. Adidev, any point want to add?
No.
Okay, then we can look for more points. It leads to wastage of resources, and also people become a liability to a country, right? See, only if the population is productive, it will become an asset to a country. If they are unemployed, what will happen? They are a liability for the economy because the government want to feed them. They are not contributing anything. But we want to protect them. So it become a liability. So one of the most important problem as a result of unemployment is the wastage of human resource. It is idle. We are not using the human resource proper, and also it become a liability to the economy. Then this point you said, it leads to poverty. If there is no job, especially it affects the lower sections of the society. If there is no employment, they have no income, they cannot spend money for food. So it will leads to poverty. Then another important point. This point, I think you didn't say. Unemployment creates depression in the mindset of educated young man. and it gives birth to the antisocial activities. Okay, educated persons, if they are well educated and if they are not able to find a job, what will happen? It will affect their mindset. It affect their mental status. It leads to depression, or sometimes the people will move to some antisocial activities. Antisocial activities means? What do you mean by antisocial activities?
Very bad activities.
Smuggling is an example for antisocial activities. Right? So, because if the people are well educated and they are not able to find a job, it will affect their mental status. Sometimes it will lead to depression for them. Sorry, Ashik?
Terrorism.
Terrorism, yes. Like that type of antisocial activities. And also, the dependency ratio increased as a result of unemployment. The dependency population. Actually, the age group between 15 to 59 is a productive population. They are the working population. But what happened? If there is no employment for them, they are coming to the dependency ratio. So the dependency population will also increase. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? Why unemployment is considered as a serious problem for Indian economy? First one is, unemployed population means a wastage of resource and it become a liability for the economy. Second point, it leads to poverty and starvation. Third one, it leads to depression. Sometimes educated, if the people are well educated and they are not able to find a job, it will lead to depression. And also it gave birth to some types of antisocial activities. As you said, terrorism is an antisocial activity. Smuggling, people will do that. And also the dependency ratio to the population will increase because no employment, they are not contributing anything. So dependent population is increasing. Clear? What happened if there is no proper employment for the people? Okay. Then the next is about different types of unemployment. So we studied what is unemployment. What are the consequences if the people are unemployed? What is the consequences? Then which are the different types of unemployment? You know any type of unemployment? Children, anyone? Have you heard about any type of unemployment?
Man, company unemployment.
There is no technical term like that. Okay. Some terms are there for telling about the unemployment. Some terms are there. Like seasonal unemployment. Educated unemployment.
Temporary
unemployment is there. That is coming under the frictional unemployment. Then disguised unemployment, structural unemployment. So there's different types of unemployment are there. Okay. Don't worry. We are studying only one or two types of unemployment. One is seasonal unemployment and the other is educated unemployment. Educated unemployment, I think you know. What is educated unemployment?
People who are educated.
And they are not able to find a job. Then what do you mean by seasonal unemployment?
During one season they might have a job, but during another period of time they won't.
So now you know that what is seasonal unemployment, and so this topic we can discuss in the next class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Any slide want to explain again? Yes or no?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Is it clear? Health?
Yes.
Role of health in human capital formation? Unemployment?
Yes, ma'am.
And also, what are the consequences if people are unemployed? It's clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Children, any doubt is there, again I'm saying, you can contact me, okay? So time over.
Yes,
next class, study these points and come, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you all.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.